Hello guys, welcome back. My name is Heston Dias and you're like Basic Marine Engineering. And the series which I started was where I share my work experience and what incidents happened and how we actually tackled on those incidents, what steps we took and how we actually managed to prevent further incidences also, and also what we did during the time. So this is the third episode, first two episodes, if you guys have not seen, you have come first time, then you have to go back and watch those two first episodes. Also, please subscribe to the channel if you haven't subscribed yet. Also press the bell icon so that you come to know about the notifications you get very early. And today the topic which I have selected was Rockaram Caesar. And when I say Rockaram Caesar, I'm talking about a main engine. If you guys who have watched my earlier videos will know that the first ship, again today which I'm talking about, is my first ship where I worked as a junior engineer. And during that time, the first ship was my Mitsubishi 6 UEC 60LA, which was Rockaram operated exhaust valves. So what was happening there was, a Rockaram lubrication, few lines were there. So as normal, on that ship I was mostly for 6 on 6 off watches, but I was from 12 to 6 at night. 12 o'clock has to come unmanned, and then I used to wait till 6 o'clock, and then I used to again 12 o'clock has to come, I used to man, I used to wait till 6 o'clock, and then I used to unman at 6 o'clock and I used to go. So what happened, like during my watch I took my rounds and all, and then at around 4 o'clock 5 o'clock again I take my round, and I take the soundings, I update, and while coming up I just heard some sound. Normally what happens for those Rockaram, there is a fixed lubrication line, but then I saw some sound coming, so I lubricated. But by that time I think it was very late and the sound was not going, so I understood there is something wrong. So then what I did was I called the duty engineer who was there on that day, and second engineer I called. So what happened, they also came, they also lubricated, they realized it is not going, so they called the chief engineer. Then what happened was, like, this ship was a 2-hour notice, like a changeover ship, like start and stop had to be done on diesel oil. So during that time, chief engineer came down, he informed the captain, and then we had to stop the ship because the sound was not going. And what we did was, we started doing the changeover. Now to change over, from the time you decide to change over till you have changed over to diesel oil, it should take along at least 2 hours. So that's why when I meant to say first, the 2-hour notice was required for this ship was because of that reason. Because whenever you decide that you have to change over, first you have to reduce the temperature, that is shut all the steam valves, then you wait for the temperatures to come down. It has to come down at least 85 degrees Celsius or 90 degrees. Sometimes it is very risky. 90 degrees, I will say it was very risky, because then the vapor lock can take place. So 85 degrees, you come, you change over. By the time the entire line is flushed, we have to wait. So because of that, we started the changeover, and we started the changeover process. But by the time we could change over, the Rockaram started, meaning normally it is having a pin here and it starts moving down. But it got so much seized that it started moving up and down, completely up and down, and it was very, very scary actually. And then when we stopped the engine, we removed the Rockaram, and then we had the bush bearing, but to remove it, it was not coming out. We made some arrangement to jack it out, and we even applied around 500 to 600 bar pressure, but it was not leaving out, and it was so scary because we had done a temporary arrangement of holding the Rockaram and pushing the pin out so that we can remove the bearing out. So it was very risky to put a more pressure than that. Then we ultimately decided, chief engineer contacted with the company and ultimately decided that we should cut off that unit and run the engine. So we actually cut off the engine and we had to run. Normally there are various methods. If you refer the manual, you come to know this on that ship it was very easy. Near the pump you have one square like rod which comes out of the pump, and that has a marking. So basically you just have to turn it 90 degrees or 90 degrees, so that what it does is basically it pushes the roller up. The roller which moves on the cam, it brings it up. So what happens, there is no pumping action taking place. Understood. So there is no pressure build up, so there is no firing, so there is no fire inside, so there is no exhaust. So that's how we cut off, and when you cut off, you have to again follow the manual. Normally it will say around 65 to 75% of the load. Suppose normal 100% load is there, you will have to reduce the load around 65 to 70%. So whatever the manual says, again you have to follow that only. So we did that, we went to the port and then we gave the rocker arm full assembly. We gave it to a workshop which came, they took it to their workshop. They did the machining and they changed the bearing and they brought, and then we fitted back, and then our ship was back to normal. The only thing then, the latest steps which we took was, we used to lubricate the all the bearings irrespective if the lubrication is taking place, because there was no way you could check it properly, because it was contained and inside, and there was no alarm for that. Even if the lubrication had to stop, there was no alarm. So the only practice was to lubricate. Now what happens when you have rocker arm on that ship? Normally when any ship, when the main engine runs, it makes a lot of noise. But when you are having a rocker arm, the noise level goes very, very high. It meaning a person who is sleeping right in his cabin can also tell when the engine has started. Even in his sleep, you will be able to tell. Any person can tell. I'm not saying a person, a first time joiner will definitely be able to tell. So that much noise level is there. And this slight change in noise level was difficult for me at that time to anticipate. Even I anticipated, by the time I anticipated, it was very late, I feel. And for that reason, then we started a practice that we used to lubricate all the rocker arms in whatever rounds, whenever we were taking rounds, we used to lubricate. So that's how we avoided. Another thing I wanted to ask you guys is, I was thinking to do also a few videos on question answers or oral questions, you can say. If you guys are interested, please let me know. I'll put a link or poll up, and let me know how you like the video. If you like the video, please give a thumbs up or thumbs down. Please share it with your friends and share the knowledge. Again, same thing I would like to tell you guys. And till that time, till my next video, best of luck. Bye. Thanks.